So today it's time to talk about this big boy, and it's really big. Like AudioCase, I have been in the talking with them actually for over a year. Because when the speaker was released last year with the crowdfunding and Kickstarter and everything, there was no possibility to test it. And I understand, they really had to release the speaker, so they couldn't send it out at the moment. But recently we got reconnected and yeah, they provided me this demo unit. So the demo unit means that this one has been used by AudioCase to showcase the speaker. And outside some small damage around the body, it works perfect. Battery works perfect and also the speaker, there's no like problems with the audio or Bluetooth or anything. So don't worry, even though it's not a new unit, at least it's a unit that works correctly. And it's even better for also for the climate and everything to really get a demo unit instead of every time new speaker. So the first impression about the speaker is it's big, it's heavy, it's almost 20 kilos, so you can take it on your own as one person, but it's pretty heavy. And the funny thing about the speaker is with this battery that you can swap out, it's actually not very big. And especially on the rear side where the battery is like put in, they could clearly have made a second slot to have a secondary battery. There's enough room, I think, on the back side to at least try to give it a second battery output, because even though one battery has a decent battery life, even like on high volume can do up to 6 hours, it would have been cool if they could add another battery slot. And let's be honest, the 20 kilos, it's not a battery. The battery is pretty lightweight, I think around 1-2 kilos. So maybe one extra battery will not kill anybody in the extra weight. So would have been cool if there was an extra battery slot. But don't get me wrong, the battery life is pretty decent and you can also connect the charger on a speaker and then you can keep going playing music. You can even play music with only the charger, but because the charger is not like an AC direct charger, you can put it on max volume or high volume. Keep that in mind. So if your battery is dead and you want to use the direct power, it can go up to 50% volume, which is still pretty loud, a lot of bass, a lot of punch, and yeah, this is really something incredible, powerful. Is it sounding correctly? Maybe not for everybody. So especially with like the indoor mode, I noticed that the bass is a lot there, so really a lot present. And the mid-tones are also there, but especially the treble are a bit falling behind. So you do have an outdoor EQ. I'll try to showcase it. It's pretty heavy. So if you push this button, you push it in with like if the speakers turn on, it will go in the outdoor EQ. This outdoor EQ, I have to be honest, is a lot better in the clearness. Also in the mid-tones, you do get a bit more of the mid-tones. But actually the bass performance, I don't like say it's better. It's a bit less even than the indoor mode, but it does sound a bit louder. And for outdoor, that's more important, of course, than the bass performance. And yeah, the indoor and the outdoor EQ, I call it like that. Both have the pros and the cons. For a speaker of this size, it's really impressive how much audio and loudness it produces. But yeah, it's also like has big two massive 10-inch drivers. And in the middle you have like a tweeter, even a little bit of a horn tweeter design. So there is a lot of power inside. It also has like a power output of 125 decibels on 1 meter. I tried it on max once with very close to the speaker and it's loud enough. I actually never use this speaker above 70% volume because it's just then way too loud, even for recording, but also for me personally in this house or outside. It's just very loud. So yeah, I have some audio samples ready for you. The first audio samples are just audio samples on the indoor or the stock EQ. But I also have some other audio samples in this video where I will like showcase the difference between EQs. So I have like the same clip with the two EQs switching between each other. So yeah, let's just first go to some audio samples so you guys can see how the speaker is sounding in this room, in this scenario, and then we go to some comparison. Some audio testing and also that comparison with the different EQs, there's definitely a lot of power inside. And even though that, again, as mentioned before, they could have included another battery slot so people could upgrade more battery life, the one battery does perform pretty well. And I did, I think, around 1 or 2 hours of audio testing and around 50 or 70% volume, and it dropped like maybe 10%, so it's fine. Again, the specifications I have here, and like the overall frequency response, it's saying 35 hertz in the lowest, and I can say it pretty much goes there, but not much lower actually. So you have some other brands that go like even a bit lower than they claim, but this one is really steady on that 35 hertz. On 30 hertz you do hear still a bit of the lower levels, but it's really, the rating is pretty solid and correct. So yeah, you have those like Class D amplifiers built in, which pretty much every brand now uses. And Class D amplifiers, I would not say they are like the best amplifiers necessarily, not for like people that like audiophile audio, even though I'm not sure who those people are, because Some audio files say wireless audio is hi-fi audio and some say it's wired audio. I am from the second group, but hey. But a Class D amplifier, it is a good solution to get the most possible output of this kind of speaker setup and also from other Bluetooth speakers around me. So yeah, Class D amplifier, even though it's like promoted as one of the best things ever, it's not the best things ever, it's just the best overall thing for portable and small solutions. So the specifications of this S10 are pretty solid and incredible. They also have the S5 speaker. Maybe they send it out, maybe not. I don't really want to focus too much on that in this video, but that speaker is, I would say, around 50% of this speaker in performance, as soon as I look at this paper. So of course, with the Bluetooth and the aptx codec, this speaker does sound very great. And of course you have those other ports on the rear for microphones, for guitars, for other things. So I'm sorry, I'm not like making music or singing music, so I'm really testing the speaker on its audio output. But hey, I'm pretty surprised about this speaker. And it's not like maybe the coolest looking speaker, or maybe even like the most rugged speaker, but its loudness, its performance, and also like the two EQs, which have both pretty solid tunings. It's just the price is really solid, like 800 euros. I've seen speakers for 800 euros. The Rubion here in the rear is almost 800 euros, which perform lower or maybe not as good for the money. But this one is definitely is for that solution. And the funny thing about this battery swapping, even though I do still think they could have added another battery inside this body, you can swap them out and you can even charge them outside the speaker and even buy a few extra for, I believe, around 100 euros per piece. And it's pretty solid they offer this option. And the battery swapping goes pretty easy and it attaches very well. And then you can power it on. You do need to push the power button in to really get it on. And those grips are pretty great. And if you want to, you can also put it on the side, but it doesn't have feet. So if you have a table like this, it will vibrate a lot. And it's just a big unit. It's pretty cool overall. Thanks again to AudioCase to send out this big unit. And also thanks to everybody who is watching this video, because it's a completely different thing than other speakers I've tested. And it's big, it's powerful, and for the price, it's good. Really, there's no issue I have encountered with this thing, and really, I'm pretty happy with it. So, yeah, would I recommend it to everybody? I'm not sure. It's pretty big, but if you really want something that's powerful, strong, if you want to do some parties over time, it's a pretty solid performer. And even for people that like use guitars or microphones, it has a lot of options to connect devices to it, so pretty cool. And even has a USB port to charge your phone. Also handy. So overall, great speaker. And thanks to AudioCase for sending it out. See you guys around.